The Avengers were a year away from assembling. So could Captain America keep the momentum going for the MCU? Released in July 2011, the story starts off with a body being discovered frozen in the ice. It turns out to be the long-lost Steve Rogers, also known as Captain America. The story then rewinds to the early 1940s to tell the story of a then-scrawny Steve Rogers trying to enlist in the army during World War II. Constantly beat down by people bigger and tougher than him, rejected by the army, he is spotted by a scientist named Erxie, who tells him he can help him become the hero he deserves to be. Because being injected with an experimental serum by a complete stranger isn't a dumb thing to do at all. Thankfully, the experiment turns out to be successful.
How do you feel?
He's tougher, stronger, and despite starting off just as a show pony, he heads off into enemy territory to rescue captured troops, which include his friend Bucky, played by Sebastian Stan. In doing so, he becomes a hero.
Let's hear it for Captain America!
Such a man! I'd follow him to hell and back, I would!
Unfortunately, the evil Red Skull, played by Hugo Weaving, plans to betray Hitler and the Nazis in an effort to control the world as the head of the tyrannical regime called Hydra, with the help of a powerful artifact called the Tesseract. Now it's up to Captain America, with the help of Bucky, sexy Agent Carter, played by a smoking hot Haley Atwell, and grumpy old Git Chester, played by Tommy Lee Jones, to stop him. Captain America, as a character, may have lacked the charisma of Iron Man, but he still represented everything that showed the good in mankind. And while there was a risk that a character well known for being a Boy Scout could have put off the most casual filmgoers, it thankfully paid off, thanks to a great cast, likeable characters, and a fun swashbuckling feel. Chris Evans is perfect as Captain America. Brave, humble, kind, and never want to back down from a fight, even if he is to lose. When he's on screen, he really does come across heroic. Is he dark and brooding? Traumatised by his parents' death like Batman? No, he's just a guy from the slums wanting to do good. And to be honest, sometimes that's enough. He brings an old school optimism. Something people had not seen since Christopher Reeve last played Superman. The rest of the cast play their parts well. Hayley Atwell is both tough and no-nonsense, but also charming as sexy Agent Carter. Tommy Lee Jones brings his usual deadpan humour into the mix.
Come on, girls.
Look at that. He's making me cry.
Sebastian Stan convinces as Roger's best friend, Bucky.
Remember when I made you ride the cyclone at Coney Island?
Yeah, and I threw up.
This isn't payback, is it?
Why would I do that?
And Stanley Tucci really brings a lot of heart as Dr. Eckstein.
This is why you were chosen. Because a strong man who has known power all his life may lose respect for that power. But a weak man knows the value of strength and knows compassion.
Thanks, I think.
The film was directed by Joe Johnston, who also did Rocketeer, and man, you can tell, as he brings the same old school charm Rocketeer had, bringing back that feel of those old cliffhangers with that real sense of adventure. In fact, I once heard someone say it was like Indiana Jones meets Superman, and honestly, I can't help but agree. That's why I fucking love this. But there are still some heartbreaking moments. When characters die, it does feel tragic. And Captain America's sacrifice does feel genuine.
A week next Saturday at the Stork Club.
You got it.
8 o'clock on the dot. Don't you dare be late. Understood?
I still don't know how to dance.
I'll show you how. Just be there.
We'll have the band play something slow.
I'd hate to step on your...
Steve? Steve? Steve?
Which also leads to Cap waking up in the modern day New York, and it really does make you feel the loss this guy is going through.
You gonna be okay?
Yeah. Yeah, I just... I had a date.
Unfortunately, Hugo Weaving doesn't make much impact as the Red Skull. He plays the part well, but because his history with Captain America is reduced to a montage, we never really feel that sense of rivalry between these two. And since Red Skull was Cap's biggest rival in the comics, it does let the movie down. Overall, with an epic rousing score by Alan Silvestri, some genuinely heartfelt moments, and good old-fashioned patriotism, this is the film that makes you want to stand up and say only one word.
America.
And that was Captain America, the First Avenger. Next up, the Avengers. Or Avengers Assemble if you're a Brit like me.